Give the people what they want. I think you guys have been wanting some TikTok reviews and audits. We're gonna dive on in, so let's cue that intro. And while the intro plays, be sure to comment your TikTok handle in the comments beneath this video. Let's get this started. Hey guys, I'm Rachel Peterson, social media strategist and TikTok expert. As of the time of recording this, I have over 250,000 followers on TikTok, plus every single month I get 10 to 20 million views on my videos. Not too bad for a mom of three over the age of 30, if I don't say so myself. We're going to dive on into some reacts and reviews and audits of TikTok followers' profiles who have asked to be reviewed and audited. So we're going to dive on in. Make sure you watch all the way to the end because I'm going to share with you some awesome resources that can support you in building your TikTok following. First up, we have Naomi. And Naomi is a freelance ghostwriter, so we're going to take a look at her profile, how things are growing. I know she's done a great job with being consistent on TikTok, so let's take a peek real fast. So first and foremost, my first glance at your profile, I really like the bio. I feel like it's very, very clear, plus a solid call to action that supports people with taking the next step wherever they want to go to. I love that your YouTube is linked. The one thing that I would say is it would be awesome to see something that has to do with what you do, which is writing, in your profile picture if possible. Maybe it's you holding up a book or you writing or something like that. I think that that would be really neat and it would showcase even more exactly what you do. So let's take a peek at a few of these videos and see kind of where we see some opportunities for growth.
Like if you agree.
Hi. Bowels of Holly wanted to know if I had any advice for new writers. And my advice is this. If you already know you want to be a writer, then it's probably because you have something to say. It could be a story idea, a book idea, a movie idea, a series idea. It could even be just a character.
Okay, so I love that you're answering the questions that you're getting from people, Naomi. I think that this is a great series start, actually. I feel like you could do so many TikToks answering questions who feel stuck, asking people to ask questions so that you can answer them. But one thing I want to share is that I noticed that your caption is apologizing for the background noise. I think you could have apologized in a comment, because the thing about the caption is those keywords are going to be what get your video in front of the right audience. So I would more likely put questions and answers from a freelance ghostwriter, or questions and answers, FAQs with a professional writer. I think that that would be really neat and it would get it in front of the right audience. The other thing as well is make sure that you use the maximum number of hashtags that you can fit within the character limit on TikTok, including your caption and your hashtags.
Oh, you're alive. I suppose that's good news for you, but it means a lot more paperwork for me. So don't expect me to be happy to see you. Of course, being alive is temporary.
I love this. I think that this is hilarious. I almost feel like you could create a name for this kind of segment of series, which is like writer problems or something like that. Come up with a catchy name so that people know it's one of a series and then they want to go and like dig through more of your videos to find more. But I think that this is phenomenal. I love it. I've seen your views continue to grow and I'm not surprised, because you're encouraging, it's very clear what you do, and I feel like I've been seeing some more growth from you, especially recently. And so I would say keep it up. Just a few minor tweaks are really going to help your TikTok account be found. So keep it up, Naomi, you're awesome. Next up, we have Annette Ferguson, Annette_Fergs. Your bio looks awesome. I think that this is really great because it's filled with keywords, it shows people exactly what you do, and it gives them kind of that next step of like, here's where we can go for more resources. One thing I'd love to see with your profile picture is if you could put like, I would like upload it to Canva and actually remove the background from this picture and then put a bright color that contrasts like your hair and skin color. I think that that would be really neat. I almost can see like a blue or a bright pink, I think that would be powerful because it would really make your profile picture pop. Now, the first thing that I see scrolling through your videos is that it kind of looks like they were batch created. And I know that that's a part of the process. I love batch creating. But one of my immediate thoughts is like, are these all just filmed in the same day sitting, you know, in the same exact spot? And so one of the things that you can do is vary up the angles that you use so that when someone goes to your profile, they're compelled to dig in more. They want to see like what's going on. And so oftentimes when I do educational videos, I'll like move my phone around so that that way we get a variety of angles and some motion in my thumbnail. So that's one thing that comes to mind, but let's take a look at some of your latest. I do see that there are some that have gone kind of viral, which is awesome. Way to go. It's a cold night in my bed in the heat of the summer. No, I've been looking hard for a lover disguised as a sinner. Okay, so here's one thing that I've discovered, and just so you know, like I have personally done this as well. Whenever something is as vague as like building a business or becoming successful, people tend to dismiss it if there's not like little actionable steps. And all of the steps here feel really big. So if you were to say something like steps to finding a profitable business, that might do a little better because it makes people feel like, okay, awesome, I know what the next step is. These things are so big that it can be difficult for someone to like want to watch it again or take notes or share it with a friend. So that's just kind of one of my thoughts. And I learned that one the hard way. So enjoy my hardship lesson. So once again, these are really big concepts. One of the things I would do is go to answerthepublic.com and type in some of the topics or keywords related to your industry and discover what specific questions people are asking. So for example, instead of recession planning, because this is a lot, dive into like one of these points, how to increase cash flow during a recession. I feel like those, each one could be broken down into its own video with super hands-on, like these are actionable steps. Basically, that's kind of what comes to mind here is really breaking everything down into little bite-sized pieces that feel super actionable and show that this isn't just high level, like fluff in any way, because I know you have so much to give. So well done and thanks for being a part of this. Okay, so first and foremost, I absolutely love your profile picture. I feel like that pops on so many levels. Well done. I also like, too, that you have a very clear bio about exactly what it is that you are all about. You're a mama, you're a CEO, and I also recognize that if you like to have fun, follow me. Now, one thing with Venmo, I know a lot of people were talking about whether or not it's worth putting your Venmo in your profile, but one of the things that I discovered is that there's kind of this like impression that if you have your Venmo in your bio, you're not actually successful. So that could be undermining some of the videos where you're talking about being a business owner and being successful. So just keep that in mind and you can decide ultimately what is best for you. But let's take a peek at a few of these.
Wipe, wipe, wipe it down. Wipe, 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 wipe it down. Wipe.
I love that one. Sorry, I'm sorry, sorry.
Psych. Please, everybody, I'm a savage. Stop it. You're not savage. You're camel toe.
Okay. So one thing I'm noticing with your hashtags is that they're super broad. That is totally fine. Just one of the things that's going to make your videos a little easier to be found and your content to be fallen in love with by all the people that should be following you because you do have fun videos is to really niche down your hashtags so that you're seen by smaller audiences first because a lot of these are huge hashtags that can be very difficult to break into, especially if you're not early to a trend. But keep on going. Make sure to niche down those hashtags. I love what you're doing. You're amazing, Amber. Next up, we have Nick Russell. Nick, awesome to see you. Okay, so first and foremost, I like the colors in your profile picture, but I'm noticing that it's like in the shadows. It's almost like a man of mystery, which you're so friendly and you're so vibrant. I feel like you could definitely get a picture that showcases you more so that the audience doesn't feel like they're following like a man of mystery who they don't really know. You want people to recognize your face. And so I would switch up that profile picture. I like your caption in your bio, be you, do you, love you, let's have fun and make people smile, hashtag just think. But one thing that I would encourage is putting more keywords about like who you are or what you do in the bio, especially if you're going to have your link as a clickable link. People don't know why they're clicking or what they'd be clicking for, if that makes sense. I only see my goals. I don't believe in failure, cause I know the smallest voices, they can make it major. I got my boys with me, at least those in favor. One thing I think that you could do with this that would be really neat is to add some text on the screen that shares the things that other people would have perceived as failures. Like, really get vulnerable here. What are the things that other people would have seen as failures, but you just saw them as like steps along the journey? I would share some of those with text on the screen that disappears. So it also helps to motivate people and lets them get to know you even better. Let's keep on checking.
Does anyone else agree with me that there are way too many people on TikTok that know how to do a backflip?
I love that one. That is so
fun. Did I miss a class or something?
Great, because this shows like your personality, and I think that this is the kind of stuff that's going to continue to grow. So I'd love to see this side of you combined with a little more vulnerability, and I hope that that supports you, Nick. You're amazing, and so thank you so much for being a part of this. All right, so let's check out Rin's profile. She's the next person on up. I help free-spirited creatives live intentionally. Live your wild. So the very first thing that I'm noticing is that in a lot of these videos, there isn't the best lighting, and this is so frustrating because it's something that automatically like kind of pulls us out of the running most of the time. I would love to see better lighting, and this is one thing that's helpful as well, is like if you, this is silly, but if you like grab a blanket and you rub your camera off before you shoot it, then you can really find, you get better video quality overall, and I think that that would really help. Let's take a peek at some of your videos.
Okay, is it just me or are you so happy that bloggers finally started putting jump to recipe on their food blogs? Cause it'd be taking way too long to read your whole life story when I just want to bake bread.
So food are, food TikToks are always challenging because the aesthetic almost never looks how we think it's going to. Even if the recipe is absolutely amazing, one of the things that you have to do is like step back and be like, would this belong in a cookbook? Like, does this look gorgeous? And most of the time when I make my food, I'm just thinking about eating it. But I would say like if you really pull back and slow down and showcase the food, maybe like put it in a different colored bowl, it'll make these things seem so much more appealing. Maybe even put the bling effect on. You want people to be like, oh my gosh, that looks amazing, versus just being a salad, if that makes sense, because I know that your recipes are so much better than that. Like, take a little bit of time to showcase the recipes, kind of like you would with photography for a food blog.
So we totally redid our garden this year, tilled it up, and planted a whole bunch of new things, really cleaned out a bunch of the weeds, and even removed some trees. So getting a lot of work done around the acreage this year. And I want to know, being in lockdown or quarantine or just wanting to live better, did you plant a garden this year? Let me know.
So one thing with that one in particular is you could share some of like the things that people don't know about planting a garden. There's something very powerful about giving value and delivering actionable steps in your TikToks that I think could do really, really well. But I like the fast-paced action of it. I like this, the speed. I think that that's neat. But then I also think that you could choose a filter that really makes the colors pop, even though the garden hasn't quite bloomed yet. But overall, I would say like really stepping back and looking at things with like an aesthetic filter will be really helpful for you, kind of like you would on Instagram or on a food blog. I would love to see more of that type of content from you, Rin, because I know you have so much to bring. Next up, we have Katya, who I absolutely adore. I noticed that she has, 6,200 followers. She's been doing some things really right on this platform. I love her profile picture. I'm not surprised she has a great profile picture. She always does. I love her bio. And then I also really like that you're doubly advertising your Instagram, which is an interesting way to make sure people are going to your Instagram to check you out. Let's take a peek at some of your videos. Taught you how to chopstick. You a fool with it, love the way you fool with it. And the way your motion. Awesome. So one of the things with Instagram hacks and tutorials is that they are very competitive on TikTok. A lot of people are doing Instagram tutorials and hacks and tips for Instagram. So one of the things that I would actually recommend is that you actually showcase you, like you with your phone propped up or set up on a stand. I know you have these, and then go ahead and like actually pull yourself away from the camera so that there's some space and you can do something interesting, like have the background of Malta behind you. I think that that would be very, very powerful and help to set you apart. Plus, like, you've got such a big personality, so only seeing you in 2D of a picture is like, that's not the full Katya experience. Like, let people see you. You know that you're loved and adored, and you're controversial by nature. So I'd love to see more of you in your TikToks. But overall, I think you're up to an amazing start, but I want to see more of you. Next up, we have Jay, and I love Jay's profile photo. I feel like that's awesome. Love that there are keywords in her bio. I think that that's very powerful. It looks like you may have lost your clickable link, so you may want to replace that with something like follow me on Instagram, or follow me if you have like to lose weight in a healthy way. So it looks like some of your videos are getting more views, which is awesome. On my own, I'm not a knight. Nigga too sharp, nigga need a knife. Check it out of juice, I don't need a Sprite. Fuck them by the tools. So these are getting really good views. One of the things I would recommend is working on, once again, like the lighting of your videos. If anytime you're going to do something with food, it can be difficult so it doesn't look like, like mush. That's one frustrating thing every time I take like a photo or a video of food, is try to make sure that the actual process of creating it looks really aesthetically pleasing. I think, for example, of this like faux desktop back here, and this faux desktop is contact paper over plywood. And I did that because I wanted a space that for flat lays that was marble looking. That's a great way to get a marble appearance for super, super, super cheap. And I think that would be beautiful. And then I like to buy certain like bowls and plates just for like photos and flat lays and things like that. You could do the same thing with your photos, and I think, or your photos slash videos that are for recipes and food, and I think that that would be really powerful. Let's take a peek at a couple more. You can do anything you want when you sexy. Money make me feel good. People don't. Yep. So once again, I think if you really improve like the overall lighting and the shooting of these videos, I think you're going to see more traction. I know you've already been seeing a lot more traction lately and you've had some growth, but I think implementing that and thinking about the quality of how your videos look is going to be really powerful for you versus just taking a photo or a video of food, because there are food bloggers and food photographers on TikTok. So you have to be really competitive with them if you're going to stand out with your food related videos. Thank you for doing this, Jay. You're awesome as always. And that wraps up another TikTok audit and review. I always love doing TikTok audits and reviews. Let me know in the comments below, what did you learn in this audit? And be sure to subscribe to my channel if you like learning about TikTok and other social media platforms. I will catch you guys in the next video. Bye, everyone.